Fabric Tip Friday again, and this is going to be one that 98% of y'all know, but these are for the new guys mainly. Hopefully some old guys may pick up something on it. It's going to be picking the brush to use for your glue. Our UA55 glue is thinned with an acetone-based thinner, so therefore it's, you know, petroleum-based. So you don't want to use your, I thought I might have one around here, just the plastic, black plastic bristle, because it could try to melt those. You want a natural bristle to use, and first people will go and they'll find these are dirt cheap, and your mind is going to be, these are almost like throwaway. Well, that's what you need to do, is throw them away. The first plane that I did, first couple planes I did 30 years ago, I used something similar to this. I mean, I had my mind set, you know, there's a 2-inch tape going down, there's a 2-inch brush, get out of my way. I'm gonna show you something. This will just cause you, when you're walking around a plane sanding and you've done laid fabric over it, you got a bristle here, got a bristle over there, that's under us another piece of fabric. They're just for putting down glue. Yeah, they're cheap, but in the long run, they're gonna cost you more. Next thing is a great idea. This sponge with this sharp edge, putting it down, that's one of the worst ideas. When you start dipping it in that, it's gonna start getting bigger and hanging, and it's just junk. Everyone's probably tried it, you know, they've left the hardware store going home, I figured something out. That's junk. I tell everybody when they want to know what kind of brush or which one, it's kind of a joke around here, which brush do you choose? How do I know I have a good one? I say, go up to the top and look at the price tag. And if you go, oh my lands, that's the one you need to use. You need a, you know, a $10, $8, $10, $15 brush. One of the things I like to look at, this, I'm not promoting this, this is just at the Lowe's, this is one of the ones that I usually go to, the clear cut. The clear cut, they do something to the edges of them that just gives it a sharp line, and for some reason, I've grown accustomed to that little bit of an angle cut rather than straight, because it comes to an angle, and I can see right where I'm putting my glue up to my line. I don't want a 2-inch brush if I'm putting on 2-inch tape, because then you're trying to control the brush on both lines. You can go like an 1.5-inch brush, you can come down one side, you can come right back down the other, and you've got the glue laid right to your line. So that's just what I like to use. And you know, and it doesn't have to be this brand, but a lot of times if it says clear cut edge or something like that, it usually works real well. It's gonna save you in the long run. I've seen Brian next door have the same brush for a year. You know, he has several brushes, the same brush. One thing I like to do is just these type cups, mixing cups. I had some here, I couldn't find one, but a lot of them I have a snap lid, just, you know, at the hardware store or something. If you get one with a snap lid and then just cut out a little hole, I think I've mentioned this on one of my early videos on just getting equipment together. That way, when you put it in, you're going to lunch or whatever, you can snap that lid on and it'll close that up and you won't have evaporation. Slowly, evaporation is going to change your mixture, but I'm going to say the first 3/4 of a day of covering with Airtech glue, you're going to learn to know what consistency you know needs to be for thick, putting fabric on, or for the thin mix on putting the tapes on. The only thing is having maybe an extra one with some acetone cleaner or something to clean the brush out. You can go ahead and, the thing about Airtech, the UA55, it can get all dried up in here. And unlike some of the other glues, with the acetone, you can rejuvenate, you might say, and turn that back to, you can have that brush right back just like that with just a little bit of work. I've did it before, and it's kind of a no-no that, you know, you spent $10 on a brush, and well, I'll just leave it in the glue overnight and I'll put the lid on it. That will work, but with that brush sitting there, and it'll sit there, and it'll get to where when you've got it clean, it looks like that. You can't get that shape out of it, you know. So, you know, if you want to keep it, you know, real pristine, go ahead and clean it at the end of the day. You can leave it in the cup to go to lunch or something like that. But it's just a little small video for equipment, your new guys. You're going to think this is going to be very expensive, but I usually buy like 1.5 inches and maybe 1-inch one just to get started. And if you take care of it, you can do your whole plane with them two brushes, no problem. Thank you.